I'm Kiera. I am one of the kangaroo keepers here at the Fort Wayne Children's Zoo, and today we're going to talk about kangaroo anatomy.
Their large ears provide excellent hearing. They can also detect vibrations of the motion of other kangaroos or predators. They can swivel their ears in all directions to pick up the sounds in their surrounding environment. Kangaroo's short fur is fairly uniform and medium gray in color. Unlike humans, they cannot sweat, so they lick their chest, arms, and legs. There's a network of blood vessels in their forearms which help cool down their whole body. As the moisture dries on their fur, it takes away the heat and cools the body. Their long, powerful legs allow them to cover 20 feet or more in a single hop. They can reach a top speed of up to 40 miles per hour for short bursts, and they can travel long distances, 10 to 15 miles an hour. They always move both hind legs together when moving, and they cannot move their hind legs independently, except for when swimming. Only females have a pouch where they raise their young. The pouch is almost like an expandable bag with an elastic drawstring on it. If the female has a joey, the pouch can open, so it is easier for the joey to get back in after exploring. The long muscular tail serves as a fifth limb for the kangaroos. They use the tail to balance themselves to travel or to stand up. The tail also assists in the movement of kangaroos when they need to move more slowly than hopping. The middle toe on the hind foot is long and strong and used as a weapon in aggressive defense attacks. It is also used for cleaning their fur. The inside toe is two digits fused together to form a grooming comb. They have five toes on their forepaws, similar to human hands, which they use to hold food. They also use their forepaws and their tail to help them move more slowly when hopping. We call this walking. Kangaroos are herbivores and grazers. They love grazing on grass and other vegetation, such as leaves, twigs, and barks of trees and shrubs. Like cows and sheep and goats, they go through a process of regurgitating and re-chewing their food to break it down and to stimulate digestion. They have keen eyesight, but they can only respond to moving objects. The eyes give the animal a wide field of vision, which help them to identify predators in the wild. They have long, thick eyelashes that help protect their eyes from the sun's glare.
Although Australian animals, especially kangaroos at our zoo, receive what they need to live long, healthy lives, their wild counterparts face new pressures each year. Luckily, the kangaroo's conservation status is listed as least concerned. This means that their population is stable. It's mostly thanks to Australians' conservation actions. Unfortunately, in early 2020, Australia experienced massive wildfires that lasted for months, which led to the loss of forests, animals, and more. It is estimated that over 1 billion animals are lost, but the Wildlife Information Rescue Education Services, Inc., also known as WIRES, is working hard to care for the wild animals that were affected. If you would like to learn more about the wildlife impacts and their work, visit www.wires.org.au. You can do your part by visiting the zoo, spreading awareness to your friends and family, and donating help to the injured animals in Australia. Be on the lookout for other Australian animals at the zoo and ask zookeepers or instructors any questions you have to learn more.